short version. There's been a desire to explore some experimental research. So I referred to one of my old colleagues, neglecting to mention his unfortunate... How to phrase this for your pedestrian mind? Corporeal roommate situation. I won't be able to do it justice. You'll need to see for yourself.
So happy you're here. And please excuse the mess. We are going through a series of difficult mergers. Chaos Agent? Is that you?
Yes. On behalf of the Villainous Council, we're here for the full tour.
Welcome to the end of our long war. Set aside everything you think you know about the Hippocratic Oath and get ready to dream.
I will hear all the screams you are capable of making.
Sorry. He is just a wee bit excited about all the scientific progress we've been making.
Yes. Hello, Hyde.
Thank you.
that for some loot. Yeah, so it's your classic Jekyll and Hyde situation. I probably should have mentioned it earlier. But as you know, I revel in chaos and disorder. Anyway, his monstrous barbarism threatens to change humanity. Literally. And the VC is quite fond of humanity as it is. Gives a villain something to dream of dominating someday, huh? So, as much as I hate to say this, shall we put a stop to this madness? think we should collect as much blue glow as we can. It could be useful later.
You're still alive!
Of course, the villainous council.
No, sorry, that's the first line of the talk. You're still alive! You're welcome! I pause for laughter, and then we go to the first slide. Distinguished colleagues.
Impudent fools!
We would like to welcome you to...
the Bacchanal of Blood!
Our talk on hybridization and the continuation of the species. And forgive me, but you're going to have to use your imagination here for the slide.
Just imagine a person sewed to a husk, and the person is crying, and the husk is screaming. It's very funny.
Imagine their mournful groans. Of the lab will have lit braziers. that a deluxe lava waterfall? It is so hard to find a lair with a pre-installed deluxe lava waterfall. Unless, this must be a renovated geothermal energy plant. His name may be the good doctor, but he has exquisite taste.
Now in the talk, we do a little breakout session.
Oh, I love breakout sessions!
They are chaotic and evil, so that tracks. Then we move on to the real meat and potatoes of the talk.
Emphasis on meat, and selling meat to other meat!
Yes, 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 we get it. Thank you, Hyde!
You're going to want to get it on the ground floor! By proceeding to the fourth floor, where the presentation is.
Something's floating in that incubation tube. Shall we break it open? Says, if a villain stokes trickery and strife, and there are no citizens around to beg for mercy, are they really a villain at all?
Maybe it's time we get to the no longer beating heart of the issue. These are not just husks. They're the solution.
Well, if we're having an honest villain-to-villain tête-à-tête, you know I can't let you do this, good doctor. The VC has reviewed your plans. This will end humanity as we know it. And we can't debase ourselves by lording over mute human-husk hybrids.
Why don't we just show them?
Come on down and be one of the first to experience the next stage in human evolution.
Thank you.
of those dreadful monsters. Are you ready for this? It could get bestial in there. Just stay unpredictable, and we'll be fine.
Yes, surely nothing is more unpredictable than walking right through the door. I hope you've enjoyed your little tour of my facilities, because it ends here.
We just want you to stop using your science to change the world. Or, heaven forbid, make it better.
Science isn't about making the world better, it's about
getting it done.
And what you're getting done is a life-changing husk implant.
I think those electrical coils are attuned to hide in the dog's physiology. If a chaotic element were introduced, it might incite a transformation. In other words, try rubbing some blue glow all over those things.
subjects insist upon surviving!
Stop surviving!
Science demands it!
We'll be right back.
science and goes unpunished.
Are you open to workshopping those as your final words?
Shut it, Doc.
Well, you've saved the day from being sane. At least I think you did. If I'm honest, I feel like his plan was one of those flashy schemes that brings in a lot of early investment money, but then fails to actually pay off or make any real meaningful change, you know?